Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Mary. Today's topic, whose mind is stayed on thee, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he had trusted in thee. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength. Isaiah 26:3-4. All of us have struggled with some decisions we have made before God. It's really tough to stick to a decision. Commitment is a hard thing. It has been that way since the beginning of time. Anyone who has been on a diet or fast knows how tough it is. Yet inside each of us, there's a stubborn streak where nobody in the world could get us to change our minds about certain things. Wouldn't it be a good thing if we got stubborn about God in a positive way? I submit to you today that there is power in the made-up mind. This is why Jesus said, I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. So because then thou art lukewarm, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Revelation 3:15-16. God actually spews out those people who can't make their minds up. This is why all of heaven rejoice over one person who repents. Repentance is simply making up your mind to serve God. What does it mean to have our mind stayed on Him? If we trust Him, if we love Him, if we obey Him, if we serve Him with all of our hearts. Listen, this walk with God is primarily an act of will. It is a choice. Every day we wake up, you are presented with a choice. Every day you go to work, you are presented with a choice. Every day you come to church, you are presented with a choice. I don't feel like praying today, but I'm gonna pray anyway. I don't feel like going to church today, but I'm going anyhow. I don't feel like worshiping today, but I'm gonna worship anyhow. There is a choice to make. God responds to a made-up mind. Moses took a while to make his mind up, but once he did, he was fully committed. Moses had the opportunity to compromise before Pharaoh, but he chose not to. There is a peace that comes when your mind is totally committed to God, and nothing in this life can replace that peace. After God called Moses at the burning bush, Moses made a decision to obey God at any cost. Though Pharaoh would not let Israel go, he finally relented and he said to Moses, you can go and make your sacrifice right here in Egypt. Remember now, the commandment from God was, go 3 days' journey into the wilderness and sacrifice. Pharaoh was offering Moses a compromise. Doesn't this sound like the devil? He gives you a little bit and just a little bit more. With anyone else, maybe they would have compromised, but Moses was willing to do what God said, irrespective of how difficult it might have been. God wanted Egypt out of their sight. Out of sight, out of mind. He wanted them as far away from their sin as he could get them. We have to be careful not to allow our worship and our sacrifice and our praise to get intermingled with Egypt. All it takes is somebody with some spiritual discipline like Moses who says, Pharaoh, I don't want to talk any longer. I'm here to tell somebody today, don't let Satan negotiate with you. As a matter of fact, don't talk to him. You feel pressure to compromise your values and your beliefs. You will feel pressure to compromise some of God's commandments. There will be influential people who come into your life that will make it seem like the right thing to do. But don't settle for anything less than what God asks for in His Word. If your mind is stayed on Him, God will take care of everything else, your family, your possessions, and your future. I encourage you today, keep your mind on the Lord. The thought of the day. If you're fully committed to God, God will be fully committed to you. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.